So let's say your dog ate your homework. Maybe it was an essay, in which case all the sentences should be pretty distinct from each other. That'll help you figure out which piece goes where, and maybe you can tape it back together. But let's say for some reason you had a weirdly repetitive homework assignment where you just had to rewrite the same sentence over and over. If your dog shreds that up, it'll be a lot harder to reassemble. When scientists sequence a genome, it's kind of like putting together a ripped up piece of paper. DNA sequencing technologies can only read out small fragments of the genome at a time, and then scientists have to analyze those fragments to determine the sequences of entire chromosomes. Like the shredded piece of paper, DNA sequences are much easier to put back together when the sequences are unique. All chromosomes have some repetitive regions, but for the most part, scientists can analyze these unique regions to assemble the sequences of entire chromosomes. However, the human Y chromosome is like that weirdly repetitive homework assignment. More than 50% of the Y chromosome is made up of these highly repetitive DNA sequences that until recently remained a mystery. The Y chromosome is also the last human chromosome to be completely sequenced, and scientists were only recently able to finish it using new DNA sequencing technologies that read out larger sequence fragments. These larger fragments are much easier to analyze, even for these highly repetitive regions. Like, if your dog shreds up your weirdly repetitive homework, you'd much rather have your dog shred it into several huge pieces than many tiny pieces. We can learn a lot from this new Y chromosome sequence, which has regions important in fertility and may also play a role in other aspects of human health. And now we can also finally say that we have truly complete sequences for all human chromosomes.